Hey guys, it's John from Album Review TV. Time for a review of the new Daft Punk record. It's titled Random Access Memories. A lot of you guys wanted me to review this, so I hope you enjoy. Make sure you check out Facebook and Twitter. Links are in the description down below, as well as my website, albumreviewtv.com. Random Access Memories, aka RAM, like is found in your computer, is a collection of songs that are just so diverse. It's probably their most diverse record to date. They've been the pioneers of dance music, and they've changed the scene multiple times with their records. And they've influenced so many people. You might have heard them sampled in Stronger by Kanye West. They're just all over the place, and they sparked like this whole generation of dance music that shows up in much of today's pop music. And the whole EDM scene that was influenced potentially by them is something that they're trying to move away from. And I love that they're still making dance music, but it's just so groovy and like old school. They're taking you back before Homework, their first album. They're taking you back to like the 70s and 80s with this dance music. You're gonna hear like disco influenced tracks, funky beats and guitar. They used live instrumentation for most of this record. They opted to use like live in the room type feel, so it seems more like raw and intimate, and you can actually, you know, hear that they're playing these instruments and they're not just, you know, pressing buttons like so many of today's DJs actually do. These guys have talent. The French duo has been around since the 90s, and they are back yet again. Many people did not think that they were going to put out another studio album. They worked on the Tron soundtrack, but that wasn't an official studio album. I enjoyed that. But on Random Access Memories, they are really all over the place. Get Lucky is the first taste we got of the record, and it features Pharrell Williams and that Nile Rodgers guitar. Love it. It's got this crazy little loop that goes throughout the entire song, and yes, it's repetitive, but it's something that I don't get tired of as I listen to it. It draws me in and it keeps my attention the entire time. Pharrell's vocals are nice, and they're nothing too amazing or spectacular or anything, but they're just kind of laid back, chill, mellow. It's something that a lot of people will sing along to. It's already been a big hit for the band, top 20 here in the US, and it's charted in the top 10 in many other countries. This funky summer jam has already been a big success. Like I said, the Nile Rodgers guitar drives it home and carries it. It's got some thumping bass, mellow but catchy vocals from Pharrell. Up to this point, we only heard the radio edit of the track, and now we're getting the full thing, and I honestly have to say that either version is fine with me. I've been jamming this song like non-stop since it came out in April. It's something that I can never get out of my head, especially, you know, when the part comes on with the vocoded vocals from Daft Punk, when it's just irresistible. It's just pure, you know, ecstasy when I hear that part of the song. It's just, I can't resist moving and dancing to that part of the song. It makes me feel like alive. Well done, Daft Punk. Perfect choice for the single. Totally understand that, and it fits in well with the rest of this album, honestly. Now, the album opens up with Give Life Back to Music, and that's a track that I'm actually really enjoying. It's a perfect opener for this record. It starts it off on a super upbeat note, and it doesn't waste any time getting straight to business. Vocoders galore, funky guitar, electronic crashes and builds. It's just intense kind of throughout. It's nothing too crazy, and a lot of people said that they felt like they were playing it safe with these opening tracks, but I really don't feel that's the case, at least on Give Life Back to Music. I think it's perfect Daft Punk. It's definitely more dance-oriented. You're not seeing much of that funkiness I was talking about yet, but it's still in there for sure. Overall, it's one of my favorites on this record. Giorgio by Morador is a very interesting track. It's Giorgio telling his story. He's a pioneer, really a producer, and he's the one that really brought the synthesizer to like a lot of mainstream attention. Produced a lot of songs in the 80s, and he pretty much just tells his story on this track. He really didn't know what was going on when Daft Punk called him up and was like, hey, we want you to feature on this new record. And he's probably thinking, what do you want me to do? He's like a 70 plus year old man now. He ends up just telling his story, and they mix it in through these beats through the background. It kind of builds slowly, and then eventually, you know, it builds into this just mainly instrumental track. And it's a 9-minute song, so it runs quite a while, but it's entertaining nonetheless. The electronics kick in and flow at this part of the song after the story is told, and after the 6-minute mark, it just really starts to lose it. It starts getting out of control. Awesome. Playing it safe? Mm-mm, not anymore, not on this 9-minute epic right here. After that 6-minute mark I was talking about, the synths, the bass, the drums all start to shine. I love the use of drums throughout this record. It's great. You can actually hear the drumming, and it's loud. It's not like it's minimalistic in the background. It's at the forefront a lot of times. Some of the most interesting sounds on this entire record come after that 6-minute mark. Creeping bass lines, turntable action, drum fills, huge synthesizers fill the end of this wonderful track. It just soars high. If this is what the future sounds like, I'm totally on board. Now, there are a few tracks that I'm not so huge on. Game of Love, it almost has a country feel to it. It speaks of heartache and has a sad overtone to it, but it does keep the album flowing nicely. I'm not going to say that it brings it down too much or anything, but it's definitely not one of my favorites. It's got a blend of vocoded vocals, guitar, and electronics, and it mixes nicely, but it doesn't work perfectly like so many of these tracks do. I definitely see the guys playing it safe a little bit here on this track, and overall it's one of the worst tracks on the album in my opinion. Within, while not something that I dislike, it's not something that I'm really on board with. Within is a balladish type disco jam led by pianos, light drums from time to time. The vocoded vocals relay a sense of yearning, loss, and loneliness. You get the feeling of distance just listening to the track. The sense of someone on the verge in life, kind of slipping into the void. A short and sad tune, like I said, not one of my favorites. Now back to something I am digging, Instant Crush, featuring Julian Casablancas of The Strokes. Love his vocals here on this track. I would have loved to have seen more of that on the new Strokes album. And he's even at times, dare I say, energetic with his vocal presentation, and I absolutely love that. Okay, I'll admit that I thought the intro to the track sounded a lot like Last Christmas, that popular Christmas song, but that quickly faded away as soon as the actual song started coming in and Julian's vocals started appearing. It's a slightly vocoded vocal performance, but at the same time you still definitely know it's Julian. It's synthy and catchy throughout, nothing too complex though. It's got this nice guitar solo that sends the listener into another atmosphere, and then it pulls you back in as Julian's vocals softly start to come back in near the end of the track. His vocals really get energetic towards the end, and that's definitely not a bad thing. Motherboard is a mainly instrumental track, mixed with some electronic flares, light guitar, and bass here and there. It builds on a steady and catchy loop, but it eventually builds into the sound that I can only really describe as liquid melting or something like that, and eventually it keeps and continues building out to this huge electronic fusion, led by some nice keys, and it never really gets too big or out of control. But it's got a nice finish to the track. There's definitely a wide use of instruments on this record, and I love that. I love that they're actually just showing how much talent they actually have and that they can actually play these instruments. Doing It Right, featuring the legend Panda Bear, actually is an amazing collaboration track. I absolutely love these unvocoded lead vocals filled with some vocoded background vocals. Sends this mid-tempo track right over the moon, and it's definitely one of the best collaborations on the record. Synth flares, wonderful production, you'll want to hit the dance floor when you hear this track. Just make sure you're not too close to anyone when you start dancing, because you're gonna be moving. Fragments of Time, featuring Todd Edwards, sounds like a Western influence jam, and it's not something that I'm digging at all. I could see some fans getting into it, but this one's just not for me whatsoever. It's got that Western flair like I mentioned, but it's got that spice that only Daft Punk can add. Then we get to Contact. It sounds like something that could have almost fit in on Daft Punk's Tron Legacy soundtrack that they actually scored back in 2010, and you'll see why if you listen to it. Spacey synthesizers, talk about something being out there. It's another one of those big out of this world tunes. It starts off with these men talking on the radio and saying that yeah, there's something definitely out there, and then it builds into this huge electronic sound. The drumming kicks in and really pushes the song forward, along with the consistent synths that continue to build throughout this track, and it just starts getting bigger and bigger and bigger. Close your eyes when listening to this track, because this song takes you to somewhere that only mind's eye can see. A place of pure musical ecstasy. And just when you think it's spiraling out of control and they can't pull it back in, they reel you back into reality. You open your eyes and you realize that the album is coming to a close and you're really sad, but at the same time, you love it because you know you can go back and listen to it again. Contact is my overall favorite on this record. Even if you don't check out the rest of the record, definitely check out Contact. It's this huge spacey dance jam that is just truly amazing. Speaking of space jams, remember that movie? We get to Touch, featuring Paul Williams. It's definitely another one that's kind of out there, and it starts with this huge thing that seems like it's going out of control. It's all over the place. All these sounds are going in your ears and you don't know quite what you're hearing. And then Paul Williams' vocals come in and it truly mixes things up. This song is one of the most diverse on the record and I can't quite follow it. It's just so all over the place and it has its hand in classical at one moment and then in just dark electronics in another. So it's a little bit, I don't know, cluttered, I guess I would say. So it's not one of my favorites overall, but I think a lot of people will enjoy this track. Lose Yourself to Dance featuring Pharrell Williams once again is very soulful and funky, sending flaring guitars and dancey vocals all over the place. The claps come in and it's on. Disco fever, baby. This song is a straight up blast from the past. The vocoded come on, come on, come on, come on from Daft Punk in the background definitely adds a ton to this track. Extremely catchy, definitely one of my favorites. And the final track to talk about is Beyond. It takes us on a vocoded adventure that sounds dark but still funky at the same time. Something that has showed up quite a bit on this record, as you can see if you've listened to the album for yourself. Funk and disco is something that definitely describes much of this record. Beyond is not quite as engaging as many of the tracks on this record, but at the same time it's still a nice electronic funk voyage. Contact closes the album on the perfect note, like I've already talked about. Daft Punk, you've truly outdone yourselves here. A lot of people were worried about this record. I don't see what people were so worried about. Daft Punk have been consistently awesome throughout their entire career, always been making well-produced and amazing dance music. They've been the pioneers of so many things, and here again, they're taking us back to the blast from the past. What do you guys think of Random Access Memories? I'm definitely digging this record. 4.5 out of 5 from me. All out dance, funk, disco record. Wonderfully done. So, what do you guys think? Let me know in the comment section down below. What do you want me to review next? I'm always open to suggestions. 30 Seconds to Mars, Man Overboard, Queens of the Stone Age, just to name a few of the reviews that are on the way. Make sure you check out all the links down below, and I will see you guys very soon. Please subscribe if you enjoyed.